I've been using Chrome for as long as I can remember. I've also used Safari and Firefox and Internet Explorer back in the day. But somehow, with all my Chrome using, I think I've found a way, unintentionally, to break it. I was traveling by train the other day to script one of my videos like I usually do, and I've been ignoring this badge up top that says pause, and this thing came back to bite me in the ass. I've told you guys this before, right? That even without Wi-Fi, I can edit my Google Docs, Google documents and sheets and whatnot. And then when I go back to when I have Wi-Fi, it updates it and I don't have to worry. But now it didn't let me get in and edit without internet. It wanted me to sign in and I need internet for that. I could have pulled out my phone and turned on the hotspot, but I finally resorted to using Microsoft Word, something that I haven't done that in such a long time. I just use Google Docs so much because I can carry on with my phone. I can read it on my iPad when I'm shooting, like today. I don't want to worry with versions and so on. So that's why I use Google Docs, but it didn't let me sign in. And the reason that happened is because of how much I use Google Chrome. So I have my personal computer, my personal phone and my tablet. I use these guys to get online and I use Google Docs a lot. I use Google Chrome a lot. But I also have a work computer and a client computer. When I go to the client site, I need to use the client's computer. So instead of writing down the passwords somewhere to sign into each of these accounts, I've remembered these passwords on Google's backup and sync. I've even bookmarked these links because there are a ton. And I just use Google Chrome, irrespective of which device I'm on, to go to the right page. And Chrome remembers my password. With work, I use Chrome so much that it can't take anymore and it's shutting me down. So the worst thing that can happen to you when your Chrome gets paused is that you need internet access and you can't use anything offline anymore. And also, all Google services that use backup and sync start acting wonky. So I wanted to find out how much of the Google services 15 gigs free storage I had to use up before it starts acting wonky. And I think for me, the number was something between 80 and 85%. Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about, Google gives you 15 gigs of storage online in one of their servers somewhere. So everything from your Google Keep, your calendar, your contacts, everything that's Google stuff is stored in these 15 gigs. And I just crossed 85%. I was expecting Google to be a little smarter. So my personal computer doesn't send out this volume anymore. It's just my work computer. So when I sign in to my personal computer, Chrome should have just accepted. But we're not there yet. Chrome is not that smart yet. I think it will in due time, or maybe we just won't have the paused batch anymore. But we're not there yet. It's like your computer or your phone, I'm guessing. I mean, it's at least a good comparison. If you have 100 gigs of storage on your computer and you fill up your C drive or your native drive up to like 80-90%, then your computer starts lagging. Same with my phone. I have 128 gigs on my phone, but if I cross 100-110 gigs, then my phone starts lagging. It doesn't search like before. It doesn't perform like before. If you don't have the paused batch, that's awesome. But the point of this video is just so that you know that there is a point beyond which Chrome's backup and sync starts acting wonky. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you next week. And until then, no, wait, hang on. Before I say keep learning, this channel is about all things tech and about keep learning. And it's a friend pointed out that it's also about good vibes only. And I completely agree. Thanks, Farhan, for that hashtag. So the last time I saw you guys, I asked you to make a fruit juice or a coffee for someone. Did you make that? I made so many coffees for my roommates and they were like, damn, thanks for all the coffee, Josh. If you haven't done that, take 20 minutes out of your schedule this week to make something for someone that you've never made something for. Make them a cake or biryani. I made chicken curry for my friends. Duck curry. Chicken curry recipe. I'll see you guys next week, and until then, keep learning.